Hi, everybody. I'm in a campground in Florida right next to this tree, and there's a lot of dogs out here, so hopefully this comes across okay. So I actually filmed this yesterday in the woods, and before I put it out, I just wanted to say a few things. Now, the question of how I make a living while traveling nomadically seems like a pretty straightforward question, but for me, it's very complex and it's loaded with emotion. It's my story of struggle, resilience, and perseverance that for a long, long time I defined as failure. Failure that would trigger my self-critic and self-doubt and caused me to have a lot of setbacks. Now, if you ever had a dream, or even if it was just a whisper in your head saying that you should be doing something different, but you really didn't know how to put that into action, I hope my story may be relatable, maybe it will form a connection, and hopefully it could be helpful. Now, I carried shame about this journey to find my life's purpose for a long time. And I tried many, many things, many different jobs, many different avenues to make money in an effort to try something that was easier or more acceptable or more traditional or more comfortable. Truly living your life's purpose means putting yourself out there, means being different. And I was trying to conform. I was trying to be comfortable. But in this journey, I found two really, really important lessons that stuck with me. And the first one is not following your path is actually more challenging. Because there's always this haunting feeling that I should be doing more. I should be doing something else. And it's always a question like, oh crap, now I have to figure this out. What does this mean? Why can't I just be a nurse and do what everybody else is doing and punch the clock and make my money and be happy? Like, why is this feeling inside of me? And the second one is that shame cannot live in the light. So this is the first time I'm sharing this story so openly in an effort that somebody can relate and maybe it can help just one person. So here I go. Thank you. Thank you for being here. So a common question I get a lot is how I make money as a nomad and how I can live this life. It's an amazing life. It's an appealing life. But yeah, that's a big question of how can you leave your job, leave your house, travel in an RV or a van or a camper and still be able to live a comfortable life. So I'm going to answer that question today. I'm going to get into a little backstory to help explain where I'm at right now and just give a little insight from everything that I've been through. So let's get into it. I've been a nurse for 20 years, mostly working in the OR. When I first started traveling, I was a travel nurse. So it's a great life, right? You get paid a good salary. You can take off time in between jobs. And I did that for a couple of years.
And I just started getting really burnt out, especially after the pandemic. I was in cities for 3 to 6 months at a time, cities that I didn't really want to be in. I just love to be out in the woods and be out in the country, and being stuck in a city for that long was really getting to me. Also, when I was working, my dogs were in my tiny camper for 10 to 12 hours at a time, and it would really break my heart that they were stuck in there. I tried to hire someone to come walk them, and they would not go out with these dog walkers. So I ended up just putting pee pads down, and they were in there for that long of a time, and I wanted to spend my time with them. And nurses are amazing people. They want to make a difference. They're very caring. And I think it's a really good profession. If you're in that profession or you want to get into it, I just did not feel like it was my calling. I never felt like it was my calling. I wanted to help and inspire people. And I felt like what I was doing wasn't accomplishing that. I was traveling, but I wasn't living my purpose. So I tried to start my own business. And this was a lot of trial and error and a lot of fighting with myself. First, I started with an e-course. So I enrolled in this program that had group coaching and a course to teach you how to do an e-course.
Right. And Hello. Probably not have the dog here. Hello, and welcome to Preparing to Launch into RV Life, where you can live a life of excitement and travel while saving money.
While I was doing that, I decided to enroll in another course that taught you how to do an e-store. And I thought the e-store is going to be a lot easier because I will be anonymous. I don't have to put myself out there, and I could be making money while I'm doing the e-course. And you know, the course said you can do it, you know, a few hours a week and make all this money. And nothing against e-stores. I think people make money on e-stores. I think people are very successful on e-stores. The e-store just didn't sit right with me. I'm trying to be a minimalist. You know, I sold both my houses, all my furniture, all my belongings. I left it with my ex-husband. And here I'm living in this camper with what I really value and what is important to me, and getting rid of the stuff that doesn't fit that criteria. And here I'm selling this cheap Chinese crap to people who probably don't need it. So then I thought, I'm a nurse. Why can't I be a nurse writer? So I enrolled in a course for nurse writing. And it's a great idea. People make money at nurse writing. So I started to get into that. I wrote a few articles. I'll link an article below in the description that I wrote about procrastination. I tried to do that, but that wasn't really calling to me either. I had so much self-doubt, and I was beating myself up every day. You know, I would get up, I would do my little routine, I would try to stick to a schedule, and I was living in fear. I was beating myself up. I would tell myself, you're not making any money. You're gonna go broke. Who's gonna listen to anything you have to say? Like all these voices in my head. And I would at times just freeze, just distract and not want to do anything. And I didn't realize that my self-talk was the root of everything. I didn't know constructive ways to deal with them, because they, in reality, they might always be there. And they're voices from the past. They're voices from a time when they protected me. And when that was my only option as a child. And now I'm an adult and I don't want to listen to those voices from the past anymore. So when they come up, I just say, thank you. I know you're trying to protect me, but I don't need your help right now. So I'm going to still do this thing. I'm going to still get up today and meditate and drink my water and eat well and exercise and get enough sleep. I feel like my purpose in life from when I was a little girl was to inspire, to motivate, to help people live a better life. And I kept getting in my own way. My social conditioning kept getting in my way. It wasn't truly me or the authentic me of who I'm supposed to be. It was all those negative thoughts of, you know, you're not good enough. No one's going to read your stuff. Look at this person on stage. Look at this person that wrote that. You're not that good. You're not that person. And the more and more I did that, the more and more horrible I felt. And there was a lot of shame associated with that. My mom would ask me, so how's your writing going? And I'd be like, oh, good, Mom. And I don't know. Have you ever done that? Have you ever lied about the progress that you're making to someone? There's a lot of shame in that. There's a lot of loss of self-respect with that. And it just made me feel more terrible. And it made me feel like those voices were real. Yeah, those voices are real. You know, I'm lying about it. I'm feeling shameful about it. So this cycle went on for 15 months. And I finally thought, the fear just got to me, and I thought, I have to take another nursing job. So I did. Last spring, I took a nursing job in Norfolk at a children's hospital in an operating room, and it was for 13 weeks. So I went there with the dogs, lived in this camper, and not a very nice campground. It flooded often. And I just didn't enjoy where I was. Being in the city, being in congestion, I just didn't like it. But I was making money. And at that time also, I started working with a coach. And she was getting me to see that my negative thinking was holding me back. She was telling me about the accomplishments that I'm doing, because I could not see my accomplishments. I thought, oh, if I did it, anyone can do it, so it's not really an accomplishment. And just getting me to look at my life in a different way, getting me to do different daily routines that uplifted me and nurtured my spirit, like my daily meditation, like getting up at a certain time, like exercising every day. And it wasn't like linear. I started working with her when I was nursing in Norfolk, and I went through some bumps and setbacks at that time. But a funny thing happened after I was there for 6 weeks. It was a Friday night. I was leaving work and I got a call from my recruiter, and she said that they're going to cancel my contract because they don't want to pay me the contracted amount that they agreed to. They will let me sign another contract for less money, and then I can stay. it just didn't sit right with me. And I thought, you know what? This is happening for a reason. And maybe I'm not supposed to be here. Maybe I'm supposed to be doing something else. So I told her no. And that's when I made my first YouTube video. I've been wanting to do YouTube for 5 years. And I was so scared to pick up the camera and film myself. And at this point, I lost my job. I didn't know what to do.
I don't want it this morning. Have you ever had one of those mornings when you're in bed and you just don't want to get up?
I was going to go back to Florida to go see my parents for Easter. So all I had was my cell phone. I picked up my cell phone and I said, this is it. I'm filming myself. I'm filming my journey. I'm filming what happened to me. And I'm putting out a vlog. And I thought no one was going to watch that vlog, which gave me more inspiration because all my life I tried to be invisible. So if I put out this vlog and nobody watches it, that's okay with me. So I did the best I could. I didn't know anything about editing. I used Premiere Pro. I taught myself the best I could. And I put out that video. And to my surprise, that video to date has gotten like 69,000 views, which blew me away. I didn't think anyone would watch this video. And it set me on a road to be a YouTuber. And with the inspiration and motivation from my coach, really, really helped me because it's not linear. You know, in our life, we have ups, we have downs, had some setbacks. But then the thing is, I have to take action. And when I take inaction and I freeze is when I am the most stressed. And I hide from the world, and that is not my purpose. My purpose is to inspire and motivate and help people, uplift people. And I don't want to do that anymore. I don't want to hide. But then again, when I do hide, I don't beat myself up. And that's the key. That's the key. So when you have setbacks, don't beat yourself up about it. Just learn from it. The next day go on, or the next hour go on. Give yourself grace. Give yourself time. Right now for money, what am I doing? I'm still living off of my savings. I am making money from YouTube, which right now I'm only putting out a video a week, which is okay for me right now. And I make on average about $200 on YouTube, which isn't a lot. I didn't expect even to be monetized for like a year, and I ended up being monetized in like 2 weeks because of that first video, how many views I got from that first video. It's gonna grow. I'm also a certified holistic nurse coach, and I got certified about 5 years ago. So I was so impressed with the coach I was working with. She was trained by Brendan Burchard, high performance coaching program. What I loved about this program is it's a structured, science-based program. So it took me through clarity. It took me through focus. It took me through psychology, physiology. And every single week, there was a different focus. And all of these things lead to a high-performing life, which is what we all want, right? So I decided to go through Brendan's program myself, which I did a few weeks ago, and I feel an inspiration now to get back into coaching. I feel I'm in a great space. I want to help people. I want to live my purpose, and I'm starting to coach clients now. So I've been in coaching programs before, and I've also been in therapy before, but this has helped me so much more than anything I've been in before. I guess because it's science-based and it has direction, and it really, really guides you to where you want to be. And I feel like this is part of my purpose, to keep this YouTube channel, to show people my experiment of one. We're all experiments of one, right? So this feels right to me for the first time in my life. This feels right to me. It's not easy. It's not easy having your own business at all. It's so much of who I am, but I kind of like that because it keeps me working on my personal growth. It keeps me doing things that keep me fulfilled and inspired. And I can share that with people. If you're interested in scheduling a free 1 hour coaching session with me, I'll leave my link for Instagram below. I'm taking a limited number of clients right now, but I would love the opportunity to be part of your journey to a happier, more fulfilling life. That is everything. That is everything in life.